Now let's go through the audio patching and see what happens with editing mono and stereo audio in the sequence. Let's start off with the audio tabs in the sequence. Here I have a sequence that contains two stereo tracks. Stereo track 1 consists of audio channel 1 and 2. There is also another stereo track that consists of audio channels 3 and 4. At the moment, you can see that with the loaded source, the patch panel is going to edit the audio into the first stereo track and overwrite my existing edit. But a typical everyday task you might do is add background music track to accompany the camera audio. So I want to edit my stereo audio onto stereo track 2. Just drag the audio source tabs from stereo track 1 to stereo track 2. Unlike video, the audio tabs do not follow the focus point. So you either drag the tab to the relevant track, or you can right-click on the track and assign the track using the pop-up menu. Please note that if you are patching a source tab to a track with an existing track assignment, the source tabs will simply switch around. Now let's talk about mono and stereo audio in Smoke and how they can affect your editing. You have two types of audio tracks that can exist in the sequence. You have a mono audio track, and you have a stereo audio track. Each type of audio track is capable of having source tabs to edit the audio, as long as the type of source audio matches. So using the standard editing convention with insert and overwrite, you can only edit mono audio to mono tracks, and stereo audio to stereo tracks. At first, this does sound strange why you can't appear to mix and match types of audio on one audio track. This is because the patching in the sequence is expecting matching formats for matching tracks. This is the same reason why you can't edit audio into a video track and vice versa. However, you can still mix audio types together by dragging and dropping the sources into the sequence as opposed to editing them with the shortcuts. This forces the edit to happen, and Smoke will comply and do what is needed to match the audio. In the case of mono to stereo, Smoke will double up on the mono audio to exist in a stereo track. And in the case of a stereo source being edited into a mono audio track, Smoke will just split the stereo sources into two separate mono audio tracks. A final function worth highlighting is track locking. The padlock icon on each track can be turned on, and this will prevent any changes to the particular track from any operation. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.